Next poolside chat features Shobhana Hadap. In conversation with her is Siddharth Karla.
Firstly, the website doesn't load as fast as search websites. But color has always been something that I've enjoyed working with. That is why my design journey started with doing comics and illustrations. And that's something that I use to my defense, because I think if you hit the right color, half the job is not done, but it's way simpler, because I somehow enjoy working with a lot of colors. I don't like to play safe. Sometimes things can go wrong, but I think once you start getting a gist of it, it's quite fun, because when you're working in branding, you get this power to decide how people will look at a brand. How will you define that brand's personality? And I think while that's a very responsible thing to do, that's also a lot of fun, because I mean, the client has probably just, whatever they've provided you is textual or some references, but coming up with a vision and how the brand is perceived, looked like, and how the messaging is communicated, I think colors play a huge role, and I think you can go all out and all experimental with them. It's important to understand what the client is looking for, even if you may, you know, remove some points from the brief or suggest some changes, but it's important that what the client is looking for. I mean, brand identity projects, you are starting off, when somebody is starting a business, they've probably put in a lot of heart into it, and they've been visualizing their own company or their own brand for a long while. So they have a certain idea that this is how my business is going to look like, or this is how I want my dream company to run, which is why they might be a little narrow-minded at times, where they don't want to experiment. But as designers, we need to open them up. Of course, we need to take into consideration what they like and how they visualize their brand. But after our research and our understanding, we need to talk to them and probably tell them the possibilities, which they might not be seeing as a layman or somebody who's not a designer. Digital marketing is very crucial for us, maybe because branding projects, identity design projects, are usually one-time projects. And to run a small design studio where you don't have that stability, you need to ensure some monthly income coming in so you can give out your salaries or pay your overheads. That is when digital marketing really helps, because these are usually monthly retainers. So I know that I can feed the tummies in my studio, which is why we started with social media. We were not really passionate about it in the start, but slowly we started getting a grip over it. Of course, you need to learn how to catch up with trends.